I love when you make something that you can't really predict or expect, and that's sort of what this is. So blue is like one of my favorite colors, so I just use it in everything. And then the magic ingredient is here, silicone oil. It's pouring.
Okay, yeah, you can
put it. No, it's fine, I like it. When I'm in the lab, I'm going because I need to be inspired. Whereas when I'm here, it's definitely like a much more quiet, reflective time. Like, if I'm working here, I'm usually writing. So I'm very much like my space dictates what work I'm doing and how I feel about it.
Hello.
I love women and I love being in spaces where women feel empowered, and my work is about women. My thesis has a name, and the name is Aloe I, which stands for Aloe Imaginations. Aloe meaning other or alternative. I'm from Kenya, I'm from Nairobi, and I work a lot in the slums. I've worked there for like 6 years, specifically with women and the girl child. And I knew that I wanted my research to sort of interact with this demographic, and the question that kept coming up for me was sort of, how do we imagine our futures? And so I sort of designed a pretty funky study in Nairobi, and I wanted to see, can certain immersive experiences lead to different language or ideas about our futures? So how do women in informal settlements interact with novel technologies like VR, and how does that affect language and how they think about their future or imagine their futures afterwards? When we're in VR, our brains act as if we are still in the real world. If you're in a headset and you think something is coming for you, you're still gonna duck. If you've lived somewhere that give you no mobility whatsoever, then that means that you've not been able to access a lot of the world. That's what I see the power of VR as. It lets you see in which you cannot see. When you're running a study of 200 African women in VR, you learn that the octoscope is not designed for black hair. My hair right now is fine, but like would work because it's like flat down. But a lot of times, you know, black hair is much bigger than this, braids are much thicker, much longer. I am trying to design a new head strap system for VR. The first part is pretty simple, like just get a Velcro strap and some nice material and wrap it round. I'm just still figuring out the top part, because the easy thing is to sort of have a strap come from the middle and attach to the back, but the problem is that the hair is all here, so I need to find a second strap system to make sure that this balances and doesn't lose weight. One of the tests is like, hey, there's this imaginary person who's 16 years old and she's a woman. Imagine the best life she could ever have. And it's been so fascinating to see how language changes depending on what experience you encountered, and how people's imaginations of the best life become like more liberated. And I don't know what that is. I'm trying to figure it out.